Hello, and welcome to my multi-character guide. As with all my character guides, this information is meant to supplement your own playstyle rather than be the only way to play the character. You may know some sweet tricks with multi that I had no clue about, so leave your feedback and ideas in the comments below. I'll start by going over some general playstyle tips, followed up with some good item synergies, and ending with some gameplay footage so you can see everything happening in real time. Also, all the clips shown are taken from my livestream at twitch.tv/woollygaming. It's all one word. Alright, let's start with some general tips on multi's gameplay. Right off the bat, you'll realize something feels a bit beefier about your robot friend, as in you feel girthier, meatier, thicker. That's because multi has the highest base HP in the game at 200. Put this in perspective, the Huntress has a base HP of 90 and only gets an additional 27 health per level. Multi gets 60 per level. The only survivor that comes even close to this is the Mercenary, who gets an additional 42 per level. So multi is very tanky. What offsets this insane amount of health, you may be asking? Why? One less base damage than the other characters, of course. Seems balanced to me. Oh, and did I forget to mention he has a base armor value of 12, which equates to an almost 11% damage reduction right off the bat? What? Anyway, you get the idea. All this info can be summed up to multi being one of the tankiest characters in the game. The only point in which I'd say he's not the absolute tankiest is in the early game, your first loop, where the Mercenary's amazing HP regen, armor, and flat HP values make him a bit tankier. Other than that, if you want to play a character that can take a few hits, multi is your go-to. As mentioned in my character guide for the Mercenary, click the white pop-out notification in the top right if you're interested in this, him and the multi are currently the only two survivors that have passives. Multi's passive is that he can hold two equipments at once, one with his fast-firing nail gun and the other with his much slower, piercing shot rebar puncher, which I'll just call the rebar for the rest of the video. To switch between the two equipments, simply use a special ability, Retool, on your R key. Keep in mind that this switches your firing mode as well. A very important detail to remember is the activation of your equipment is not canceled by using your R. I'll go into details of why this is important in the following item synergy section. Multi-shift is essentially a faster sprint that gives you a massive 66% damage reduction, which is 200 flat armor, and does some damage if you hit enemies. This damage is particularly effective versus larger foes. Now, the wiki states the movement speed bonus is 45%, which is the exact bonus you already get from sprinting regularly, but if you literally load up the game right now, pick multi, and test the speed of the sprint versus the shift, you'll instantly tell that the shift is quite a bit faster. So I don't really know why this info is on the wiki. Perhaps they meant the sprint speed is multiplied by 45% during your shift, which would make more sense, but in that case, this info should be phrased a bit clearer, in my opinion. Anyway, I mentioned the shift does some damage. If you use it to damage smaller enemies, like regular Lemurians, Imps, and Wisps, good luck hitting the Wisp, by the way, you will continue to glide through them until the shift's duration is over. However, if you use it on a large enemy, which is anything else, you will rebound off of them, dealing a pretty good burst of 1000% damage and stunning them, if they're not a boss. This also ends the effect of the shift, so keep that in mind if you are using it in attempts of escaping something. The armor buff you get during shift will definitely save you in certain situations. See a big jellyfish about to use his boom? Let's find some cover. There's none. Just press your shift and get a hefty 66% damage reduction then. Problem solved. Oh, hey, let's go check the top of stage 4 to see if it's a legendary chest. I missed a platform. Oh, this fall damage is gonna hurt me. Just press shift, baby. Your armor value dictates the amount of damage you receive from all sources, not just monster hits. So using shift right before you hit the ground will drastically reduce the amount of fall damage you take. It should be noted that the only exception to this rule is the Shrine of Blood. Armor does not mitigate the Blood Shrine's damage. Multi's secondary skill is the Blast Canister, which I just call Bomb, which deals some damage and stuns on impact, releasing some secondary bombs that do the same thing. This is a pretty useful skill to launch into groups early on for some AoE damage, as well as interrupt a Stone Golem Beam or a Lemurian's Fire Breath. Its damage is fairly good, and if the large bomb crits, then all the small ones will as well. However, his main damage comes from his M1, specifically the nail gun. This weapon is crazy. It has a proc coefficient of 0.4, meaning on-hit effects will happen 60% less of the time compared to using everyone else's M1, which has a 1.0 proc coefficient, but the rate at which it attacks more than makes up for this downside. The base speed is 12 attacks per second, as in you start the game, level 1, start holding down left click, you are attacking 12 times per second. That is very fast, to say the least. Start stacking a few attack speed items, and oh baby, this thing turns into a straight-up minigun. I find that his nail gun is superior to his rebar in almost every situation, and therefore keep the rapid fire M1 held down in like 99% of situations. Really, the only time I bother using a rebar shot is if I have to snipe a flying enemy that game physics away from me. If you haven't noticed yet, the flying enemies can sometimes go a little further than usual when they're struck. Those are basically the only situations where I use the rebar to finish them off after traveling much too far out of range. It is good to note that the rebar does pierce enemies, so if you're in a situation where you have loads of enemies piled up or in a line, you may want to take a few shots at them with the sniper. To sum this overview up, focus on constantly strafing around while holding your M1 down to throw out your bombs off cooldown. Save your shift to get away from big threats like Titan beams and jellyfish explosions, and remember that the armor buff it grants will definitely save your life if it comes down to it. Also, don't forget to pick up two equipments. Let's move on to some great item synergies. I'm not going to cover every single possible combination of good items on the multi, but rather pinpoint a few and talk about why they're particularly effective. Do not take this section as a complete build or as the only items you should look for. Getting an early ukulele is absolutely amazing on him because the rate at which you're firing turns your nail gun into pretty much an AoE attack with all the chain lightning going off. Pair it with a little bit of attack speed and some on-hit effects. If you didn't know, Tesla and ukulele both can proc your on-hit effects, and the damage becomes insane for single target and AoE. Speaking of attack speed, syringes and predatory instincts are also amazing to get early on in a run, and pairing them both with some crit glasses will help keep your predatory stacks up much more consistently, and then you'll just be attacking even faster. Getting at least one Hapu feather, especially by stages 3 and 4, is key in keeping you alive. Multi is a bit more sluggish than the other survivors due to almost always holding down M1, so no sprinting. Therefore, the extra jump allows you to dodge greater wisps, clay dune striders, and brass contraptions attacks. Speaking of holding M1, because you are hitting so frequently, leeching seeds and harvester scythes turn your nail gun into a rapid fire healing button. Your 0.4 proc coefficient does affect the amount of healing received by these items, however, your attack rate more than makes up for this downside again. Finally, fuel cells are essentially twice as effective on multi due to him holding two equipments, as mentioned in the overview. Whichever equipment is in the form you are not currently using will continue recharging and gaining stacks, so you can hold something like a prion in your rebar form, switch to it for a second to fire the shot, and then continue back in the nail gun form while it recharges. For specific equipment, as you might imagine, there are quite a few combos available with two. If you like blowing things up, I recommend doing a duo damage setup with either two prions, two capacitors, or one of each. Generally, I like to keep my more consistent damage equipment, meaning the capacitor, on my nail gun form, simply because I'm in it most of the time. It makes sense to keep the equipment you use most often in the form you were always using, instead of constantly switching forms. However, these equipment combos are situational. For example, if it's early in the game and I've yet to gather an impactful amount of crit, which I'd say is like 40% or higher, then I go for the ocular HUD as one of my equipments. As mentioned before, switching between nail gun and rebar does not cancel your equipment animations. This means if you begin something like the charge up of the prion, the scanning of the radar, but most importantly, the crit of the ocular, it is not interrupted when you switch weapons. So, if you slap the ocular on your rebar, activate it, and switch to your nail gun, you will retain the 100% crit chance for the usual duration and also be able to use the prion or a capacitor or any other equipment right away in your nail gun slot. The new equipment will also receive the 100% crit chance. However, you need to be careful about which activation you do first. If you have an ocular and a prion, for example, and begin the charge of the prion, switch to the ocular, and then use the ocular, the prion will not get the crit chance. The ocular needs to be activated before the other equipment's effects begin, not during. The gnarled wood sprite is also pretty effective on multi. The item's effect is that when it's sent to another player, they are instantly healed for 10% of their HP. However, if you simply use your R and then switch to the other equipment, and then immediately use it again, the R, to go back to the wood sprite, it counts as sending it back to you and will heal you for the 10%. This whole process can be repeated very quickly, about once per second, to get some pretty clutch heals off if you take a huge chunk of damage. Also, sprinting does not interrupt your R, so you can endlessly run away while spamming these heals. Alright, and that pretty much does it for everything I wanted to say about multi. If you have any suggestions or feedback, please leave them in the comments below. I read it all, I promise. Enjoy the gameplay, and if you like what you see, consider following me on Twitch at twitch.tv/woollygaming. It's all one word, twitch.tv/woollygaming. All the clips shown are taken from my stream, and I'm streaming about 4 to 5 days out of the week at the moment. Thank you for watching, and be on the lookout for my final character guide, the Commando.
Left a to-do list in the control room. Okay, cool. Thank you. I'll check it out. Wait, Car, you're supposed to be in bed. Hey, go to bed. Hey. Or get out of here. Whatever you're doing. Go to work. Go spend time with your girlfriend. Go hug your mom.
How does Clover work with crit?
Same way. So if you have a 10% chance to crit and you don't crit, it'll just roll that 10% again. I'm going to print like 4 of them.
No, I lost a leeching seed already.
All right. Everything's coming from your seeds and I have a scythe. Or 2 sites, so a lot of it's from that. Oh, I got my own clover, okay. Now that's interesting. Oh!
Okay, falling through the map.
Oh, bye-bye. Oh, they're both dead. Oh, okay.
Yo, stun grenade printer, whoa!
Where's the magma one? Yeah, another terror. Oh,
I got magma worms on me.
All right, I'm coming. Oh, if I don't die to these imps here. Oh, no. Yeah, I am super strong right now. Meat hook plus clover, man.
Eewee.
Actually, just clover. That's all I need right now, clover. I'm coming. Oh, there's a magworm over here. Where's he going?
Yeah, he's coming for you.
Want some of that booty. Some of that multi booty. Another fungus right here. I am lagging. Whoa. I'm shooting my prey on over there to help you out. Shoot all of them. Is that another scythe? Nice. It's actually crazy. And a goat hook. Finally, some mobility. I'm gonna spawn this combat train. Overloading worms. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that. What do the bands do? 8% chance to proc on hit. The fire band does a fire tornado. The ice band does a big ice explosion and explodes enemies. But if you have both bands, so if you have the ice and the fire, not two fire, not two ice, it has to be one of each. Then what will happen is they will always proc together. So you don't get a 16% chance to proc. It's not quite how the odds work, but it's... If one procs, the other will always go off with it. So it's very, 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 very strong. Oh, that magworm's already at half HP for the overloading worm. Gotta get my crayons off. I'll probably do more damage to the auto attack. Yeah, the hit markers are awesome. Worm dead? Nope, not yet. Where is he? He's over here now. Oh, let me... No! Oh, that was too close. That was too close for comfort. Whew. How is he not dead yet? There he goes. We got here. All right. Go, go, go. Have a good day. Thank you, man. Have fun getting some groceries. Are we doing that, Tyler?
Doing what?
The gold orb. You want to do that?
You can.
Nah, we'll probably both die. We don't want to risk the run on that.
Find them, it's never worth it.
Yeah, it's never worth it. You only get the Titanic Knurls. It's not worth it. No. Cars, don't you dare. Don't you dare, Cars. I think we're ready for the boss. Yeah, you're Skull's definitely crit. I heard a unicorn. Whoa! I'm zooming in the foreign room. Alright, spawn the boss. We're wasting time. That was another chest. Never mind. Oh, is that a sticky bomb? Heck yeah. It's either a key or a sticky bomb. It's a sticky bomb. If I can get up there. Now he's on my sticky bomb. Oh my. What is happening? Everyone's critting. Ah! Give me the sticky bomb. What the heck? Oh my gosh, I can't get the sticky bomb. Help, Chad. I can't get it. Ah! There we go. Jeez, man.
Yo, Roland.
Uh-huh.
I got something for you.
What? Oh no, I can't. I can't, dude. If it was closer to me having to go, then yeah, I'd do it. But no, not yet. Not yet. Not yet. No balls won't work. It won't work this time, chat. Wait, do I have 200k gold? Oh my word. Let's spawn the boss for real. Like, no joke. All right, here we go. Blast it. Oh, come on. The Dune Striders? Oh, no. It's a blazing Dune Strider, too. Are you dead?
Yep.
When did you die? Oh, I'm about to die.
Ah. Right when you spawn the boss.
Did he insta-kill you?
Yeah.
My bad. If I can hit once, I'm pretty much dead here. Oh, like that. Oh! Come on, Preyon, go! I am lagging. Oh my word, chat, I'm lagging so hard. How many stacks of burnings do we have? Like 80? Holy crap. Look at the lightning orbs go. Get them, boys! Oh my god. Never seen it before. All right, we gotta do it. We gotta do it for Miss Nemesis. Mr. Nemesis, I'm sorry. Or maybe Miss. Yeah, I got it right. We're doing it, boys. We're doing the gold portal. You have successfully no-balls me. 8 cage. How many things have we activated? 5? Oh, he's gonna spawn. I have the last 2 right here. I'm going. Come on. Come on. Come on, baby! Get him! Get him! Oh, he's spawning. No! I think I'm dead. No, I'm stuck! I'm stuck! Are you kidding me? Oh my, we had that too. No! Tyler, do it! The memes. The memes are the point, boys. This is the run. Oh my gosh.